Hey, welcome to Monster Transmissions. You're with Curt here in Curt's Corner. We got a lot of questions about stall speed. Stall speed, what does it mean? How does it work? So I'll give you a quick overview on exactly what stall speed is and what it means to your application. So in a factory vehicle, where there's Ford, GM, Dodge, or even other vehicles, when you have an automatic transmission and the engine's idling, let's say it's idling at 1,000 RPMs, for example, when you put it into gear, into drive, whether it's reverse or drive, the RPMs will go down, but the engine will not shut off, will not stall out. Like on a standard transmission, if you were to release the clutch all the way without accelerating or raising the RPMs, the engine will just leap forward and stall out. Well, the automatic, to prevent that from happening, all that energy is spooled into the converter. So the engine will reduce RPM about 200 to 300 RPM, so your idle will jump down anywhere between 800 to 600 RPMs, but it will not stall out. And what is happening is all that energy, or the stall speed of the converter, has now kicked in. It's spooling that energy, and so the stall of the converter is around anywhere, we'll take it at least 800 RPMs of your engine down. So for example, you want a 2000 stall converter. A lot of people assume that you have to raise the RPMs of the vehicle up to 2000 before the transmission engages, and that's inaccurate. The correct way to calibrate your stall speed, if you had a factory cam, factory engine, and you went with a 2000 stall, and the factory will say 1600, so it would just take 400 more RPM to actually engage the actual converter, engage the drivetrain of the transmission. So it is not exactly to the RPM spec because it's based on a lot of factors. Now the factors are also the horsepower and torque of your engine, the size, the lift and duration of your cam, your tire size, and your rear end gear ratio. So all those play factors on the actual stall speed of the converter, and that's why they offer a range of stall speeds because of all those variables. So it's important when you give us the information on your engine and your cam and your rear end, those are critical items we need to calibrate or dial in the converter to the correct stall speed that you need for your particular application. So this happens to be a Dodge converter here, so it actually has a very low stall, something around 1300 stall, because it's going on a diesel application. It's a more beefed up unit, but when you get inside the unit, you notice there's an array of turbines. So the angles of the fins will determine part of the stall rate, as well as the stator itself. The stator fin angle, the angle of these fins, will also determine the stall rate. So, and also the diameter of the converter, you know, the circumference of the converter, also has a factor on the spooling or the ratio of determining your stall speed. So all these play factors in determining your stall speed. So the stall of a converter is relative or directly tied to the cubic inch size of your motor, the horsepower rating, your cam, so we need to know the gross lift and duration that the valves are held open. So we need lift and duration of your cam, as well as your rear end gear ratio, and your tire size. All those are important factors to dial in the stall speed for your converter. So stall speed basically spools the energy of your motor to the torque converter before it releases it to the transmission. So that's how stall speeds work and how that's important on the performance of your vehicle. If you have any further technical questions, you can see us at Monster or go to our website. Call our number to ask for a tech, and it's 800-708-0087. Talk to you then.